Yeah.
Everybody's definitely in frame right here.
Are you recording?
Yeah. So we can watch it back. So even, and then this is like...
Good morning, everybody. How are we doing today? Today is Monday. It's October 9th. It's about 9 o'clock in the morning, roughly. And I've had an incredibly busy weekend. And I think as you can see, I might look a little bit different. Not so much me, but what I'm recording with. And I'll get to that in a minute. But I figured before I jump into Monday, I would bring you back to Friday because a lot has happened between now and then. So let me bring you back to Friday morning. Good morning, everybody. How are we doing today? Today is Friday. It's October 6th. It's currently about 8 o'clock in the morning right now. And as you can see, I'm already hitting the road pretty early on my day off for a rather interesting reason. But before we get to that, I have a really, really important package I gotta pick up.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Good. How are you?
I'm well.
I have a quick question for you. For the weekend or the week?
Well, I am on vacation next week.
You are.
I am. Okay, and your signature?
Do that.
5-star cards.
Okay.
Cool.
You got them everything?
Thank you, yes.
All right.
I do. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Have a good day.
You too. Thank you. All right. What's on the inside of this package and this package is incredibly exciting, but because of the time that it is and I have to go get my... I don't have time for this right now, but these things are incredibly, incredibly exciting. We just gotta attend to them later. So, we'll get back to it. So I'm driving about an hour and a half east of where I live into central New Jersey, into a town called Plainfield, New Jersey, which is actually the town of the hospital where I was born in. I was raised in Metuchen, New Jersey, which is like another town about 10-15 minutes away from that. And the reason I'm headed over here today is because I went to get my passport the other day, you know, at my local post office. And when I arrived at the post office, the people that were there said I couldn't get a new passport. And I was really confused and I was like, why can't I get a new passport? Here's my birth certificate. I have everything right here for you. It's the official one that's I have everything. Why can't I have a new passport? And like, I need this passport because this is for the missions trip that I'm going on that I just talked about in my last vlog. So I really need this thing. And they told me I couldn't get a passport because my passport didn't have my parents' names on it. It just had my name only. And I was like, yeah, I mean, it's my birth certificate, you know, it's not theirs. I was the one who was born, you know, shouldn't my name be on it? And they were like, yeah, we realize that, but you need to have your parents' names on your birth certificate. And I was like, okay, well, like, what do I do? Do I just write their names on there? Like, what do I do? And they said, well, you need to get a new birth certificate. And I'm like, a new birth certificate? How do I get I was born once. Like, you can't redo, like, how do you, what? That's not something you do twice. And so I was like, how can I get a new birth certificate? All I want to do is get a passport here. So I did what I always do when I'm confused and I have no idea what to do. I called my dad. And now my dad didn't really know what to do either. He thought it was kind of weird, but he said, you know what? What he would have done, and this is what he told me on the phone, is call the municipal building of the city or the town I was born, tell them the scenario, and see what they can do for me. And I was like, it makes sense. I'll give it a shot, see what happens. So I called up the municipal building of where I was born. I told them my situation and they said, yeah, that's no problem. All you gotta do is come in on a weekday between 9 and 4 o'clock, bring X, Y, Z, which I have with me, fill out an application and you can walk out with your new birth certificate same day. And I was like, done, I'll see you Friday. All right, good, that's a real solid start, real good.
Hi.
Hi. Sorry about that. I can hold it up for you if you want. Need some help?
Have a good day.
Yeah, right. Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem at all.
I'll come back.
No, it's all right. Take your time.
Hi, how are you?
Well, I don't even know if I'm in the right position. So I'm here to get a new birth certificate.
Vital statistics.
Okay. I think I'm in the right location. She said as long as I fill out this application right here, get it back to her, she should be able to pull it up and then print out a new certificate for me. So, as weird as this feels, I think I'm in the right spot. Should be good to go. It's time to just wait it out. Still waiting. This place has bathroom keys? It's kind of like a hall pass from high school or something. Boom, got it, headed home. All right, so I'm back home. I got my birth certificate. I gotta set up my post office appointment to get the passport. I gotta do all that, but I'm home now. And do you remember this morning how I got a package that I was very excited about? All right, what's on the inside of this package and this package is incredibly exciting. Ooh. Camera, battery, charging things. And to start anyway, I'm gonna start, you know, getting more lenses as we go, but I kinda wanted to test out this camera with just a general, obviously very wide angle vlogging lens and see how we do. That's really small. Well, the goal is to try this Sony camera instead of this camera and see if it's any different. Let me show you, let me switch back. Does it look any different? Should sound the same because I have the same microphone on there and everything, but it should look different, I think. I can't see it because there's no flip screen, you know what I mean? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use this camera for the rest of the day, see how I like it. I really won't know until like later when I take a look at the footage, but I'm gonna give it a shot and see how it goes. Hi, can I place an order for pickup, please? It's gonna be really, really, really interesting to see how this thing performs. I have not... Why are Mustangs so loud? Like, they don't need to be that. For those of you who don't know, some of you, a lot of you obviously know, but some don't. Our video production company, 4LC Studios, that I work with, Scott, we use Lumix GH5s. Before that, we used to use Sony A7S2s. We absolutely loved them. But the GH5, in our opinion, honestly yields a better image and it has a lot more, I don't know how to explain it. I feel like they just work better. They have a lot more buttons and they just do a really, really good job at getting us what we want and making it easy to get there. But the reason I'm telling you this is because I haven't used a Sony camera in a while. We've used the GH5s for a few solid months now. So it's been a while since I've used a Sony. Now, I personally love Sony. I think they yield an amazing image and they have the best autofocus in the game and they're amazing in low light and they just do a really, really good job at creating films. But here's my thing. There's no flip screen. So I can't see me right now. Like, I'm used to seeing me, you know what I mean? Like over there, and I can't see myself. So I don't know if I'm in focus. I'm assuming with Sony, you're most likely in focus 99% of the time because they're the best at it. I have no idea what my exposure is right now. I also don't know what my audio levels are. So I feel like I'm kind of playing a risky game here. One thing I do like about not having a screen is I don't have to focus on the fact that all I have to do is look at you. And that's nice. Just feels risky though, you know? Something I gotta get used to. I don't even know how I'm framed right now. I'm assuming, you know, with the wide lens, I'm pretty well framed, but I don't know because I can't see it. We'll see.
Hi.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm good.
Okay, awesome. Cool.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Have a good day.
Thank you, too. I appreciate it. Thank you.
I got the stuff.
So, yeah, that was Friday. It was an eventful day. A lot happened, including getting this camera right here, which is the Sony A6500. I'm still learning how to use it. Like, I don't fully understand everything on it yet because it's, you know, it's so new still to me, and I'm going to be seeing Scott in a little bit, so he's going to definitely help me with some of the settings and different things and options, and I'll definitely be on the ball soon. I'm excited to try this camera as my new vlogging camera and see how it works, and so far, the picture that it yields is freaking awesome, but I got to use it more. I got to see if I love it and go from there. Now, Friday was really fun, but then Saturday was even crazier because I had to film an entire wedding by myself. See, Scott was away at a men's retreat this past weekend, and he was leading worship there with a group of musicians, and we had a wedding booked, and it was only a one cinematographer wedding. Now, Scott was going to go to the men's retreat and then leave and film the wedding, and I was like, you don't have to do that. Like, that's a lot on you. So let me go ahead and I'll film it, which I did. Good morning, everybody. How are we doing today? I have the camera case at my house today. Isn't that weird? All right, it's Saturday morning. It's about 8 o'clock. We have a wedding today. Let's get it going. Made it to Lancaster. That was a really long day. So yeah, like I said, it was a long 12, 13 hour day by myself, moving things and getting in the right place and making sure I get all the shots by myself completely. And I had a really weird audio situation. I mean, it was a lot of things that happened, but nonetheless, I got the shots, I filmed the wedding, and I'm excited to show Scott the stuff later on today. It was my first time filming a wedding completely by myself, so that was very exciting. I also forgot to mention, Sunday was awesome. We led worship at church, and then right after church, Jake, Bobby, Jenny, and myself went to like our local pumpkin patch, and we took pictures. They also had apple cinnamon donuts. Unreal. Like, absolutely unreal. So, yeah, that was a quick snapshot into my weekend. Obviously, a lot happened. Like I said, I'm excited to try this camera out and see what it yields and see what it does for me. So far, I love the look. I'm not a big fan of no screen, but at the same time, I'm a fan of no screen because I can kind of focus on you and not so much the screen that you would normally be over there. So, I don't know. This thing's pretty cool. But I gotta learn the settings, so we should probably head to Scott's. He's definitely gonna help me out with that, and it's Monday, so we gotta get to work. I'll see you over there.
Alrighty.
See ya in the morning.
I'll see ya. So this is supposed to look different now then? All right, I know that was like a horrible transition. Last time we spoke, I think it was about like 9 o'clock in the morning, and it's currently about 5 o'clock in the afternoon. And see, I knew Scott was gonna find something in the settings that I was doing incorrectly, which he did find, and now it's fixed, I think. Again, I won't know until I edit, but I trust his judgment. Let's do this. Quick change, Chick-fil-A. We've just arrived at Faith for worship practice. Whoa. Is that the Glen Carolyn?
Check, check. Yeah, that might have been it. Oh, check, check. Is it at 64?
Hey, brother.
How are you?
How are you, buddy?
Good.
Okay, I have to go get drumsticks real quick from the other room. All right, so like I said, I'm at Faith Church, and basically for the next 2 days here at Faith, they're shutting the building down for normal use, and they're basically going to put everything together for a conference that's happening with all pastors in this like region, I believe, that all have like an association with Faith Church, and it's basically going to be like 200, 250, I think, pastors getting together for a conference that
basically, I actually don't really understand or know the reason, but they asked us to help lead worship, and we're going to be doing that for the next 2 days here at Faith. Not in this big main room where we usually are. This is actually where they're going to have like lunches set up and everything for everybody. We're actually in the other room that I just was in, but I have to get drumsticks first because they have me playing drums, which I'm really excited about.
Check, check, one, two.